Hey Finders, and welcome back to Fortune Finds. Today, I'm giving you guys a Sephora haul. It was like one of those unexpected, like I spent all my money Sephora trips. Go to buy one thing, buy five things, and you end up like spending all your money. That's kind of a similar situation as to what happened with me. So all of these are from Sephora, except one thing. I did throw in this Lovecraft Beauty. I think this is an indie brand. I received this in my Ipsy bag in November. I use this to contour a lot of my face. Bronze it, chisel it, you guys know the deal. Before we hop into it, which we need to hop into it because I have a lot of things in front of me, please be sure that you're subscribed and also click that bell button next to the subscribe button. This way you get a reminder every time I'm uploading a new video here on my channel. We're 400 deep. I love it and I would love more of you. So if you're watching my videos and you're not yet subscribed, maybe this is like the second or third video that you have come across on my channel, hit subscribe, help a girl out. I would love to have you. So without further ado, let's stop babbling and let's get on to my Sephora haul tutorial video. Not that you can see it, it's a little overwhelming for me, but I'm filming with new lights. Mike bought me some box lights for Christmas. Super, super sweet of him. So I'm really excited. We have some new lighting. I'm also borrowing Mike's mic that he bought because he kept saying he's going to do a podcast. I'm really waiting for the podcast because I think it would be hysterical, but he has yet to use this mic. So I've took it upon myself to adopt it. So this is the Touch and Soul No Problem Priming Water. And this just says that it is a flower, water, and oil. At the last step of skincare, apply 1 to 2 drops of water oil on palm, rub your hands, and press gently on the face for better makeup application. Love this packaging. Look how pretty that is. Oh my God, that is so pretty. And it has like, this reminds me of my Kiehl's Youth Dose Eye Cream. It has the same kind of applicator. Massaging it between my hands. Oh my God, that smells lovely. Oh my God, so lovely. Oh my God, what is in this? This smells so nice, you guys. I wish you could like come through the screen and smell this because, oh my God, it smells nice, it feels nice. Oh my God, okay, I don't think if you have oily skin you're gonna like this because this is very oily. It has the exact same consistency as my Tarte Maracuja oil, those drops. Remember those were like really in? Please like don't even ask me why I spent the money on this. I mean, we're gonna see. I feel like it's really nice. I tried it on in the store. This lovely lady at Sephora, Laura. I always go to Sephora and no one ever asks me if I need help. And this woman really truly cared and was like so excited about the makeup, and her and I were just melting over the makeup products together. It was like quite an experience. So I feel like because of her, she is honestly the reason why I have all these products. Like she is the reason why I went to Sephora and spent like $300. Okay, so I'm not really sure how to open this. Okay, you twist the top. Oh, I hate that. Is that really how you open this? Oh no, oh God. See, this is what happens to me. Okay, I just twisted the entire top off. You don't need to do that. There's really something wrong with me. I hope I didn't just break this top because now it's like all loose, loosey-goosey on there. Damn it. With sunscreen, this has SPF 20 in it. Natural glow foundation, and it is a 16-hour wear. It felt really nice on my skin. They say this is like skincare in a jar. Like it has a lot of great properties for your skin. I will list them up here. I did not come prepared for this video, and the fact that I only have an hour and a half to get ready is really making me nervous. So I'm gonna put the helpful, nice skincare ingredients on the screen here. And we're gonna hop into this, and I'm gonna use my It Cosmetics Complexion Perfection Brush. Stipple this onto the skin. It has like a really faint, it's kind of like a little perfumey. But it's like a nice scent, you know? I don't know, it's not like too overbearing. So that has a really, really light coverage. It feels really nice on the skin, but I do remember that I didn't love it initially at first when Laura first put it on my skin. It kind of took a little while for me to like it. It kind of like takes a moment to absorb, and it was really textured when she first put it on, but then it kind of does like melt into the skin. I'm gonna take my new concealer. I'm not gonna put this under the eyes yet, but this is new. This is the Shiseido Synchro Skin Self-Refreshing Concealer. And I bought the shade 202 Light Claire. I need a new concealer and I need a new foundation. I'm sick of the ones that I have, but I loved how cute this was. How many ounces of product do you get in this? 0.19 full ounces. Excuse me? How much is my infallible one? 0.33. Oh my God. Oh my God. This better be the damn best concealer I've ever tried. I didn't even think of that. Like, it didn't even dawn on me that you weren't getting a lot. Okay, because I'm cheap AF, I'm not going to use this on my lids. No, no, I'm not. I'm going to put some Tarte Tape Shape on my lids. This is the cheapness in me coming out. I'm going to put this on my lids just to prime. But I will use that concealer underneath my eyes where it really, really matters. Let's go in with that Marc Jacobs Highliner. I'm just going to draw this all over the lid. This might be the worst idea ever. And actually, I already know that it is because this is not even showing up. I'm gonna do this. I'm going to take this and I'm going to put it on my lash line just to brighten up the eye. I do get really, really dark in there. All right, whatever. It's fine. I don't even care. This is me being salty. I'm being a salty, salty Sally. I hate this Marc Jacobs. That color is so pointless. Sorry, I'm being nasty. Okay. This is the Lovecraft Beauty. I'm not sure what this is. I'll put the name of it on the screen and down below. I'm going to hop into this shade right here. This is in the shade Cymbeline. Oh, I don't know how the heck you say any of these words. Okay, Cymbeline. Jesus, help us. I'm going to take that shade with a pencil brush, and I'm just going to put this into the crease. This is a really pretty color. NARS single eyeshadow in the shade Nepal. This is like a really, really pretty color. And that literally matches the Glitz Blitz. All right, I'm just going in with my finger. Like, I mean, clearly I have a taste for things that are so light you can't even see them. I'm gonna hop into Aditya. I don't know. I'm gonna go back in with that pencil brush and we're gonna use this contour palette as an eyeshadow palette because you know what? I said so. I'm gonna deepen up this crease. And then I'm going to throw some glitter because I have some glitter down here. This is so pigmented. But then it blends out really, really nicely. And I'm going to connect it in the corner. Like you guys know I like to do. Blending brush. This foundation is like really sitting on my pores. Like no pore blem my ass. Now I'm going to hop into this Artist Couture. I'm really excited for this. Hopefully this performs. This is the Spotlight Glitz Diamond Lights Finisher. Take a small flat brush and I'm going to start in the center and then, oh my God, and then move it out. Wow, that's really freaking pretty. Shine bright like a diamond. Okay, so I kind of tilted my head back and then placed some glitter into the crease just to give like a brightening effect. Love this. This is so freaking pretty. Oh my God. I really hope that this stays. My fear is that this glitter will fall, but we're going to see. This little flat brush, I'm going to hop back into Aditya, however you say that. And I'm just going to put this on the outer third of the eye. I'm going to go in with this Marc Jacobs Metallic Liquid Gel Eyeliner, shade Star Magic, and it's kind of just like a rose gold, and it kind of matches the rest of my eyes, so I'm just going to go in with this and do a little wingy. But this is like somewhat new. I did use this in a video for the first time not that long ago, so I haven't used it since. I'm going to use this Stila Smudge Kajal in Espresso, and I'm just going to tightline this in the waterline. I'm going to bring it into the inner corner and connect it. Just like, I love, like, I don't know. I like a tight lined eye lately. My eyes look crazy and my face is really red. So we need to get on to the rest of the face because I look like a freaking lunatic. All right, let's just pray that the face beat kills it and really makes up for this eye look. Am I just being like a negative Nancy? I'm really mad at how little product you get in here. Just saying. I'm just gonna apply it like that. And I'm gonna use this to highlight just a little bit. Like, is this doing wonders for me? I don't know. Wow. I feel like it's not as textured as Tarte. And it was really easy to blend that out. Wow. Love this. So far. Usually when I go like back and forth like this with my concealer, it gets really bunchy. But it's like not being bunchy at all. It looks good. It's not very textured. I'm going to go in with a little bit more, just like right at the bottom of that circle that I have. And I'm going to go in with a damp beauty sponge. This is an EcoTool sponge to maybe get a little bit more coverage. I kind of want to put a little bit more foundation on the skin. I'm going to put this layer on with a sponge. We're going to see what happens. I don't know. The smell is like a nice smell, but it kind of like reminds me of like my grandma's like bathroom, like in a nice way. My skin is like a really nice satin finish. I just don't like how you can see my pores really through this foundation. I definitely want to try this again, and I'm going to use my Tarte Clean Slate primer that really fills in the pores. I'm going to use that. So stay tuned for a wear test. I'm not going to be wearing this foundation very long. Mike and I are going to go out to dinner, and then I'm going to come home, rinse it off, and go to bed. I would like to get an early night's sleep so I can film tomorrow. So I don't really plan on wearing this for a really long time, but I am going to do a wear test. Maybe I'll film that tomorrow because I do have time tomorrow. So stay tuned for that. I'm kind of loving it, but I think I could love it more if it had that primer underneath it. Like, I think I need to finesse this to make it work, but it feels really, really nice on the skin. Like, it feels beautiful on the skin. It feels like so soft, and it's not really gripping too much to the dry patches. It is a little bit on my chin, but I feel like all of my foundations have been doing that. So, but I feel like this is the kind of foundation where it really like breathes as the day goes on. So this is the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Contour Wand Easy Contour Sculpt, and this is in fair to medium. It says to twist open, gently squeeze to release product, twist close, then apply. What? Oh my. Okay. We're just gonna go for it. And I'm just gonna apply it straight out of the applicator. Oh, that is really dark. Okay. I'm definitely gonna put some on the nose. Oh, wow. Okay, so far I really like this. I really like this applicator. Oh, wow. That is a nice, nice shade. Look how chiseled my... Oh, no. I'm nervous. You know, like when you have like a die-hard product that's so affordable and you're like, nothing can be better than this. Okay, this does dry down pretty fast though. So you're gonna have to work. Don't dilly-dally like I just did. But this shade is so nice. This is a really nice contouring shade. Wow, this blends out like a freaking... What happened, guys? What happened? I love this. All right, let's see. Okay. Let's not like get too ahead of ourselves. I'm semi freaking out. I'm not gonna open it. I'm just gonna take what is ever left on the applicator. And I'm gonna stamp that out. I don't have a new setting powder, so I'm gonna use my Banana Essence Brighten Up, you know, this one. I love this contour wand. Oh my God. I'm so happy that I bought this. Where did it go? I lost it already. No, seriously, don't I? Okay. I really like this. Oh my God, guys. Bronze up the face a little bit. I'm going to use this Lovecraft Beauty once again. This really like helped save the day. This shade right here, and I'm going to pat it into the back. Wow. This is a really nice contour powder. That's a great shade too. I'm basically just putting this bronzer where I put that contour. Look at that jawline, damn. All right, I'm just gonna take this fluffy brush. I'm gonna take Cymbeline, I don't know how you say that, but the lightest one again in this, and I'm just gonna contour the sides of my nose, make it a little bit straighter. I'm really excited for this as well. I hope this blows me out of the water like the Charlotte Tilbury contour wand did. And honestly, this powder thing is really great too. This is the Jouer Blush Bouquet. It's just like a duo blush. I really love these shades. So I'm gonna go in with a hit of both. I'm gonna mix it up between the two of them. Dip into the darker shade and a little bit of that lighter shade, and I'm just gonna keep it to the tops of my cheeks. Oh wow, it's kind of taking... It's not really agreeing with this. It's a really pretty color, but I feel like it kind of moved my foundation a little bit and made it a little bit muddy. Well, that sucks. It's just like really choppy. It gives a really beautiful sheen, and I do like the color. But I think the next time when I wear this foundation and I want to use this blush, I need to set the foundation with the translucent powder and then go over it with the blush. I think that'll help the powder blend a little bit easier on the foundation because it was kind of just grabbing to the foundation. Now let's finish off the lower lash line. I definitely want to smoke it out. You guys know I like to smoke out a lower lash line. Savior of the day. Savior of the vid. My favorite shade. I'm going to take that on a pencil brush. I'm just going to smoke out that lower lash line. The medium shade, and just smoke that out a little bit further, starting on the outer corner and then bringing it in. Cymbeline, Suniva, Aditya? I have no idea. Let me know. If you know how to say it, let me know down below. So I'm going to take the darkest shade with that same pencil brush. And I'm just going to hug it right here on the outer third. And then bring it on in. In the realness of being in a rush, because I'm really in a rush, I'm going to let that dry. But I'm going to move on to my lips before I flake that off. So let's use Pillow Talk. I took them out today and I didn't use them. So I'm going to use the Pillow Talk Lip Cheat Lip Liner. This is really nice, super creamy, but not so creamy where it like slides everywhere. You guys know how I feel about that. A really creamy lip liner. Like it has somewhat of like, it kind of fights with you a little bit, which I like. Pillow Talk lipstick. I like how this is shaped. Oh, that smells good. Kind of smells like chocolate. It feels really nice though. And I love the packaging. Oh my God. So retro. Okay, let's wipe this guy off my face. This is the makeup look. I love how this turned out. However, I'm gonna go get changed, maybe look a little bit nicer, fix my hair, because Mike and I are actually going out to dinner. Just to give you guys the full rundown, because I have been wearing this for a little while. I did go change. It took me like 20 minutes to get changed and ready. I think that this foundation is really nice. I will say it feels really great on my skin. It's not one of those foundations where you're not gonna feel it. Like you definitely feel it, but it doesn't feel heavy. It kind of feels like a nice serum and moisturizer on your face. It kind of gives that really nice skincare feel. The only thing is it does adhere to my troubled spots. I have very dry skin on my chin, and you can see it's kind of like grabbing onto that dry patch of skin right there. Overall, I think that this foundation is really nice, and I think that I can get it to where I need it to be. So stay tuned for that wear test. Make sure that you click the bell next to subscribe, because you'll get that notification when that video goes up. It'll be one of my two upcoming videos where I do a full day wear test of this and then this contour wand, because this really blew me out of the water. It blends it out seamlessly, and I cannot wait to see it side by side with my Ardell Glam Touring. So this is a really great purchase. I think that this contour shade is perfect for my skin. You guys saw when it went on, I thought it was a little too dark, but I think overall in the end it did a thing to my face. It looks really good. Naturally contoured, not bunchy. It really blended really nicely. It blends it out really nice. Like, it looks really good. I'm a really big fan of this. As far as the concealer, as of right now, I like it. It is kind of sitting in my bigger lines underneath my eyes, but TBD. It does have a satin finish though. I wouldn't say that my under eyes are too matte. They do have a nice little gleam to them. Overall, I do like that concealer. Just the question of whether it's worth the price is really like TBD, because I do need to wear this a little bit longer and see how it wears. No pore bloom. I'm kind of confused because my pores are out and ready to have a party. While I do like this, I think this is more of a hydrating primer than it is a pore erasing primer. I have to say, this is a really nice nude. It kind of reminds me of my MAC Faux, so I'm not really sure what the total hype is with Pillow Talk. However, it's easy to build a nice lip base with this. Very soft, almost like cushiony. I'm curious to see how this wears. This really was not that pigmented. There's nothing really exciting about this shade. I bet you have this shade in any one of your palettes. Sorry, NARS. I do love me a NARS. Anything. Artist Couture. Like, this is so beautiful. I highly recommend this. I think it would go better with a different foundation, or I think it would go well with any foundation as long as I put some translucent powder down before. I love this shade. I love me like a muted, peachy, like bronzy tone blush. I just feel like it gives a really nice natural, like, I mean, look at that cheek. That's a beautiful cheek. It just kind of grabbed onto the foundation. You could feel the brush was kind of like fighting. So I think that's pretty much it. If you like this style video, then please do be sure to leave it a thumbs up down below. This way I know that you enjoy it and I'll make more of it. Also be sure to subscribe and click that bell button again. This way you get a notification every time I'm uploading a new video here on my channel. I would love it if you would subscribe. I would love it for you to come back and hang out with me, because I really enjoy this. So I had a great time as always. Thank you guys so much for joining me, and I will see you in my next one. Bye, finders. Mwah.